Shouldn't we, as entrepreneurs, be going after the biggest possible market opportunities first? Turns out that that's not a good idea. This principle is similar when learning to play a sport. You'll learn a lot more from playing against someone who's slightly better than you. But if you start playing against someone who's a lot better than you, a top professional in the field, you'll only learn that a professional is really good at the sport. You'll get dispirited, and you might as well be watching from the sidelines. You want to find a market where you have the ability to totally dominate that market in a relatively short time period. And narrow focused markets is the best way to do this.
We start with the education space in general. And then when we look at the education space, what we started to focus on was high school, so secondary schools. And within those secondary schools, we look specifically at schools with FIRST Robotics programs. And what FIRST Robotics is an after-school program where students work with each other within a school to compete with other schools to build a robot that wins the competition.
This is very interesting, AJ. What makes a school with a FIRST Robotics program better for you as a beachhead market than a school without one?
A school without a FIRST Robotics program really needs to see the educational merits of the 3D printer. And the reason that we go for the FIRST Robotics programs is to demonstrate that, one, this technology works, and two, that there is educational merit to this technology.
Of course, this process can't go on forever. In AJ's case, the EnvyBots team realized that they should be looking at not just the education, not just the secondary schools, but a very specific subsegment of the secondary schools. You want to continue segmenting until your market opportunity matches the following three criteria that define a market. One, the customers buy similar product. That's a necessary but not sufficient condition for a market. Two, the customers have a similar sales cycle. They expect products that provide them with a similar value proposition, they're sold to in a similar way, that we can shift salespeople from one customer to another, and they will be very effective. They won't lose any productivity. And third, and this is very important, for a market to be true market by our definition, it has to have all three of these conditions. There must be word of mouth between the customers in this market. If you get one, they tell other people in that market.